reimbursement of expenses such as air travel or accommodation from its clients will save themselves from paying service tax on it. That's the Delhi High Court ruling, as it says the charging of expenses on reimbursements will lead to double taxation. Avantika Gore tells us the implications of this order.
In an order that could have far-reaching impact on service providing companies, the Delhi High Court has ordered the current rule of levying service tax on expenses charged does not hold. In an order pertaining to a company called Intercontinental Consultants and Technocrats, the Delhi High Court ordered that Rule 5 of the Service Tax Rules of 2006, which determines the value of the taxable consideration, is ultra-vires to Section 66 and 67 of the Finance Act 1994, which deals with levying and evaluation of service tax.
There was a challenge to this very Rule 5 itself as to whether this rule is intra-virus the section or the provisions of the service tax law. And what the Delhi High Court has held is the charging section, which is Section 66, and the valuation section, which is Section 67, allows the government to levy tax only on the taxable service portion, and therefore the expenses which are incurred while rendering the services should not be liable to service tax, is what the court has held.
The High Court ruled that such a tax regime amounts to double taxation. The rationale held by the court was that expenses such as air travel, accommodation, etc. were already subject to service tax as they are included in the final bill of the service provider. Therefore, charging a service tax on these expenses would amount to double taxation. The order says, and I quote, "It is true that there can be double taxation, but it is equally true that it should be clearly provided for and intended. Double taxation cannot be enforced by implication." While the order certainly brings relief for companies, experts believe that the order may have overlooked the availability of input tax credit.
The fact that after introduction of CINVAT credit scheme in 2004 particularly, most of the expenses that are incurred by the service provider are available as input tax credit to the service provider, and therefore to that extent, to my mind, with due respect to the court decision, the argument of double taxation, or the basis of holding non-taxability of these expenses only on the basis of double taxation, to my mind is open to challenge.
This judgment will impact all companies that lend themselves to services, be it an IT company, consulting firm or a construction company. But experts say this ruling could have repercussions for the government, as it stands to lose crores of rupees that reap from taxation on this specific item.
The service sectors, which are like management consultant, event management services, construction services, architectural services, these are typical services where there is a high possibility of service fee being coupled with out-of-pocket expenses or reimbursable expenses. I think those are the services that may get impacted and that may get cheaper if we assume that Delhi High Court decision is going to survive.
But the question remains if it's the end of the story, as the government still has another legal remedy before it.
First, the lower bench of the Gujarat High Court rejects it, then the division bench allows it, and now the legal battle between the Income Tax Department and Vodafone SR for the demerger of its passive infrastructure business lands up in the Supreme Court of India. Isha Shekhar takes us through what transpired in the courtroom.
Supreme Court has issued notice to Vodafone SR Gujarat Limited over Income Tax Department's plea challenging the demerger scheme of Vodafone Gujarat and Vodafone SR Infrastructure. Now, Vodafone SR has to file a response to this in the next 4 weeks. Solicitor General of India Rohinthan Nariman, who appeared for the Tax Department, sought the constitution of a larger bench to examine the larger questions of tax avoidance in light of Supreme Court's January verdict that had rejected IT Department's claim for capital gains tax on the overseas deal between Hutchinson Group and Vodafone. According to the counsel, the judgment was being relied upon by various high courts, but there were still larger questions of tax avoidance which were yet to be addressed. Now, to give a background of the case which had triggered this, the Vodafone SR Gujarat Limited, along with six other group firms, proposed a scheme to demerge its passive infrastructure assets or its tower businesses to Vodafone SR Infrastructure in 2007. The IT department had objected to the scheme on the ground that the transfer of Vodafone SR Gujarat's assets to Vodafone SR Infrastructure by way of the gift was with the sole objective to avoid paying capital gains tax of 3500 crores and stamp duty of 600 crores. Now, this is payable on the transfer of the assets estimated to be over 15,000 crore. On the other hand, Vodafone had justified the demerger scheme with the claim that it would maximize the value of its businesses and improve the quality of services to customers. It also depended upon the sanction which was already given to the scheme by the various high courts of Bombay, Calcutta, Chennai and Delhi. Now, the IT department which first won the case in the Gujarat High Court single judge bench went on to lose the case in the division bench of the High Court. It was after this that the appeal had been filed in the Supreme Court. Now, the outcome of the case is not only important for Vodafone, but it will also have an impact on similar demerger arrangements made by other telecom majors like Bharti and Idea. Apart from that, larger questions related to payments of capital gains tax and stamp duty for scheme of arrangements under the Companies Act might also be clarified by the Apex Court. And if the bench takes the view that the larger questions of tax avoidance needs to be addressed as requested by the Solicitor General, then all the eyes from the tax and the legal world will be on this matter.
Well, with that, we have come to the end of this week's episode. Do send us your feedback on our email ID and the Twitter handle flashing on your screen. Thank you for watching The Courtroom. We will be back next week.